IVM.
Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashton Doctor, your habit coach. And today's fun fact of the day has to do with lies. Did you know that it is easier to lie to people in writing than when speaking face-to-face? And this is because you can fabricate a lie better when you have time to think it over and ponder it. When you are face-to-face or on the phone, you're giving out a lot more information by the tone of your voice and the look of your face. You know, I had a girlfriend back in college who would say, "Look into my eyes when you're telling me something." She wanted to see if I was lying or not. But that is, again, total rubbish. Liars actually make stronger eye contact when lying. I used to find this whole thing really funny when she used to say it to me. We have all kinds of lies. Big lies, small lies, white lies, and default lies. You know, how many times have we answered, "How are you doing?" with a simple, "Good," even though you might be going through a massive breakup right now. That too is a lie. That "good" is just a lie. The truth is that all of us are liars. We lie all the time. But we don't recognize them as lies. We lie to our kids when they ask us difficult questions. We lie to our parents. We lie to our friends so that we don't hurt their feelings. And we lie to our bosses for sure. And then we lie to ourselves. The little lies that we constantly whisper in our ears. "Oh, you can't do this. You're not good enough. You're good for nothing. Do 10 push-ups right now instead of 20. No one will know the difference." It's not cheating on your diet because French fries and tomato ketchup is basically a salad. So, we all do these things. And we only notice and remember the big lies we've said. We only remember the times we said something true that was hard. Today's podcast is not about making you stop lying. Oh no, God, that would just make liars out of both of us. But today's podcast is about understanding what you lie about. You see, the mistake we make is that we focus on the lie. "He said this, she said that, I said that." And somewhere along the line, we try and figure out what the truth is behind it. But that is pointless. Instead, I want you to recognize what is the intention behind the lie. Why did you need to say that lie? You will see when you look back at all the lies you tell, you will notice a theme. It is this theme that will bring you the best insights into yourself. It'll guide you on the areas you need to work on the most. Because lies are nothing but the realities we don't want to accept. "I can't meet you for dinner, not because I'm sick, but because I'm nervous to meet you." "This t-shirt does not make me look fat. I am fat." Notice what are the things you lie about all the time. And I'm not talking about the big lies. I'm talking about the small ones, the everyday ones, the white lies. What are they about? What is it that you're trying to get away from? What is it that you do not want to say or hear? You see, when we answer these questions, we get a deeper understanding of ourselves. And as your habit coach, I want to see you improve your life every day. And along with the habits I share that help you on this journey, there are habits that help you understanding yourself and mastering yourself. And this is one of them. Knowing who you are is half the battle. The lies we tell and hide behind help us in understanding ourselves. So your simple habit starts by telling a lie. Then notice the lie and ask yourself, "What was the truth? What was I lying for? What would happen if I said the truth?" Notice these are all questions starting with the word "what." I do not want you to ask the question "why," but only "what." Start noticing this on an everyday, every lie basis, and you will see a huge difference in your life and in your self-identity. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashton Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's Awesome180.
I hope you enjoyed that show. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, Siet and Cred. We really appreciate the support. It is what makes this possible. So it was a fun week on Cyrus Says. We had guests like Dolly Singh, we had Guneet Monga, we had Kamya Jani of Curry Tales, and Cock and Bull, as we always did. Do check it out. I think you'll really, really enjoy that. On Paisa Vaisa, we crossed 300 episodes, and Anupam was joined by Akhil Handa, the digital head of Bank of Baroda. All things policy discussed topics like the 100 years of China's Communist Party, the Facebook versus the Government of India case, and the evolution of Indian science. On The Wire Talk, Siddharth Bhatia was joined by Gautam Bhatia to discuss the Central Vista project and why it's attracting so much flack. Sadaf and Archit are back on the Naan Curry podcast, and this time they raise the temperatures as they discuss the beloved spice mirchi. On the Millennial Athlete this week, Tanvi and Shlok speak to Sarita Chauri, a visually impaired judoist. And finally, I want to ask you all to give a listen to the Triangle Offense. Anybody who has heard me talk on a podcast knows I can't shut up about basketball, and these guys know more about it than I do. So if you enjoy basketball, do check this out. Nishant and Monish do an excellent job with this show. I was one of their guests a few months ago, which is how I met them and tried to convince them to come onto the network, and they're finally here. So definitely do check this out. Show's available on all major podcasting platforms, but they also have a daily YouTube episode, which is available on the IVM Podcast channel. And with that, I hope to see you again next week.
We live in an age of disruption, of immense change in every aspect of work, life, and business. But is the old way of doing things truly dead? And are we ever going to stop saying the new normal? Join me, Varun Dugirala, on Advertising is Dead every Tuesday as I talk to entrepreneurs, leaders, creators, and changemakers from across business, media, marketing, and beyond to dig a little deeper into how we got here, what we're doing now, and where we're headed. You can catch all the episodes of Advertising is Dead on the IBM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.